What kind of a society could have received such a high praise for Mao Zedong? With this question in mind, I continue to search for an answer in Changsha.
This plain farmhouse, surrounded by a bamboo fence, is the site of the founding meeting of the New People's Study Society, and also the former residence of Cai Hesen, an early leader of the CPC.
In 1917, Cai Hesen went to Changsha to study and lived with his family in rented accommodations. It was here where his schoolmates, Mao and Xiao Zisheng, often talked freely about transforming Chinese society.
As we can see, there is a square table and several benches in the middle of the central room. It was by this table on April 14, 1918, that Mao, Xiao Zisheng, and others established the New People's Study Society.
新民学会呢，是当时咱们中国的一个非常重要的一个社会团体吧。当时确定的宗旨是革新学术，砥砺品行。第二年，1919年五四运动就爆发了，他们呢就把学会的宗旨做了修改，就是改造中国与世界。为了实现这样的一个目标啊，毛泽东对他们新民学会的会员做了分工，一部分呢是留在国内进行调查研究，了解国情。 一部分呢，就到法国去勤工俭学，比如说蔡和森、肖子生、李维汉，继续寻找改造中国和世界的道路。While
working and studying in France, Cai Hesen translated a large number of Karl Marx's works and wrote letters to Mao in China. In letters dated August 13 and September 16, 1920, he proposed establishing the Communist Party of China without fear, stating the theories and steps needed for the party's founding. Mao replied, "This is a very good idea and I could not agree more."
Mao, who stayed behind in China, started the Xiangyang River Review in Changsha in July 1919. He was the chief editor, introducing and spreading new ideas. Li Dazhao believed that this was the most important and insightful periodical in China. Several progressive youths, such as Ren Bishi, Guo Liang, and Xiao Jingguang, began to awaken under its influence. Mao commented that it had a great influence on the students' movement in South China.
这批新民学会的会员呢，他们自尊高远，为了实现这样的一个宗旨，刻苦的学习，积极的锻炼，做好各方面的准备，为承担更重大的责任而努力。新民学会 很多人都成了咱们中国共产党的第一批党员，或者说早期的党员。新民学会呢，可以说为咱们中国共产党的建立啊，准备了成员，也准备了干部，还给咱们准备了一个共产党的领袖人物。In
1921, the New People's Study Society completed its historical mission and ceased activities. However, that did not entail the end of Mao Zedong and others to push the revolution forward. The house where I'm going to is Qin Shui Tang number 22, exactly the former secret base of the Communist Party of China in Hunan.
This house is 就开始筹建党的地方组织。同年的10月，建立了中共湖南支部，这也是中国最早的省级支部。毛泽东任书记，委员由何须恒、易立荣。这是一个两进三开间的楼空版的木质结构。右手间这间房子是毛泽东和杨开慧的卧室，左手边这间房子就是省级支部 召开会完毕以后，晚了，这些委员呢就歇息在这个地方。后面是会议的房间。毛泽东在清水堂一年多时间，是他这一生革命生涯当中最幸福，而且最浪漫的事。因为他上有老，下有小，两个小孩都是这个房间诞生的，一个毛岸英，一个毛岸青。这三位是中共湘区委员会的委员，第一位呢 是李少奇，第二位是李维汉，第三位是李立三。
湖南支部当时人数比较少，随着这个工作的开展，党员队伍啊 也在不断的发展。到1922年5月份的时候，经中央批准，建立了中共乡区委员会。毛泽东组织工人运动，组织农民运动，组织学生运动，进一步的传播马列主义，传播俄国十月革命。这个期间呢，比较大的一个成果呢，就是组织了安源路况工人大罢工。资方呢，对工人让步了，在一线和资方谈判的那是这个刘少奇，组织工会的那是李立山，但是总的领导是毛泽东，应该说做的是很成功的。1923年7月份，中国共产党在广州召开了第三次全国代表大会，党的领导人陈独秀对中国共产党地方组织的工作做了一个总结，他说呢，只有湖南的同志工作做得很好，唯独呢对乡区委员会的工作给予高度的肯定。
Nowadays, the New People's Study Society and the Hunan Region CPC Executive Committee have become a symbol of value for Chinese people. Slogans of burning youthful passions, creating regretless lives, and let the world hear the voices of the young Chinese will inspire generations of Chinese people to realize their own Chinese dreams.